Good evening, everyone. Joe for afternoon. I guess still afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Joe for JaspysHobbyland.com here. Our last case of Bowman's Best Baseball for the time being. Pick your team, number 11 from the website. Thanks very much to these following people right here for getting things going. Appreciate it. Filled pretty quickly, too. Appreciate that. Joe with the San Diego Padres is last spot in Mojo, and there's everyone else. A lot of great prospect hunting here in Bowman's Best Baseball, so I appreciate everyone giving this a try. Four autographs per box, so there's a lot of chances for you to hit. So play to the whistle on this one for sure, because you never know. Never know what you can get. Just one hit could change your fortunes. Can turn things around immediately. So good luck, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, as I mentioned, it's pretty much all prospects for the most part, but I think per case, or for most cases anyway, I think you'll see like a vet auto in there too, like a pretty legit vet auto in there. All right, good luck, everybody. Four, Jason K. Four. Two per mini. All right, good luck, everybody. Box number one. All right, there's Evan Longoria leading us off. Remember, vet base does not ship, but obviously stuff like this will ship. Colby Allard for the Braves, Jacob Hill. Per mini, so in cases like this, this is called a master box, Jason K, and these are considered the mini boxes inside. So that's the distinction. There's a nice Riley Pint, 008 out of 250, one of their higher draft picks, right? Yeah, fourth overall. Nice. That goes to the Rockies. That's out of 250 going to Andy Owens. And the second autograph out here is Garrett Davila. That will be the Royals. Lloyd with that one. Nice one. And we'll be randomizing these mirror image cards off at the end of the break, too. We'll ship them to either the left or the right side. All right, second mini box. Steven Matz. Nice. Nice one for the Mets. Richard Crester with the Mets. And Alex Bregman, nice. Nice Alex Bregman autograph. Who got the Astros in this? Daniel, nice one, Daniel. You hear what Dave Stewart said the other day? Who's obviously not the GM of the Diamondbacks anymore, but he regrets trading Dansby Swanson. No, really? Now we've got a 31 out of 50 Matt Manning for the Tigers. That'll be Jake. All right, so a couple numbered cards and a nice start. Astros, Mets, Royals, Braves. He regrets trading the number one overall pick. Now, I suppose you can make the argument at the time that, hey, maybe Diamondbacks were in win now mode. You know, they saw a lot of upside in Shelby Miller, which there was. There's a lot of upside in Shelby Miller. But the worst case scenario happened for them, basically. You know, Dansby Swanson went up the minor league ranks relatively quickly, at least for the Braves, and seems to be a legit star. And meanwhile, Shelby Miller struggled with injuries and just struggled with just pitching in general last year. So worst case scenario happened. But I mean, even if you saw upside in maybe, you know, you just signed Greinke to a big contract, you want to try to get, you know, another pitcher maybe with upside like Shelby Miller to join the team. Do you trade your number one? I mean, you, if you have the luxury of getting a number one overall pick, you make that pick kind of assuming or hoping that that player becomes at least a regular starter, right? That's what you at least have to expect from, you know, from a from your number one pick. But I don't know. I don't know if you trade it. I don't know if you trade that pick away. Imagine all the research that you get, that you've got, to, that your you and your ball club goes into trying to, trying to figure out who you're going to take in that number one pick. Crazy. Well, it was a mistake, Dave Stewart. All right, next box. James Tyon leads us off. And we got poor Alex Reyes. 53 out of 99. That goes to Nick LaPlante. There you go. With the Cardinals. And your autograph is Cal Quantrill. For the Padres. And that's Last Bought Mojo, Joseph G. There you go. And a Chris Bryant. Wow. Chris Bryant autograph. Cubs, Michael G with that one. There you go, Mike. 6 out of 50. A Bowman's Choice autograph card. That's pretty nice. MVP, Chris Bryant. And another autograph, Anthony, a bonus auto, Anthony Alford in here too. Jason Lee with the Blue Jays. There you go, Jason. Getting you on the board. Hopefully we can get everybody on the board. All right. Alex, I'm going to brutalize his name. Krill? Kind of looks like Krill. I wish that I and the R were reversed. Krill. Well, hindsight's always 20/20, right, Pack Fresh? Pack Fresh saying that back in the day when I asked him if it was a good trade for Shelby Miller, he said no. And my hot take at the time was that it was. I like the aggressiveness. Kirillov. I think I can get that. I'll remember that next time. Oh, that Twins auto goes to you, Karen. And the Elias Diaz autograph for the Pirates goes to Rick T. Or Meat until he's in the big leagues, right? If I can't pronounce your name, it's just Meat until you hit the big leagues. Nice. All right, so that was a really nice box. Well, maybe it'll be a hot case, King D. So we got Pirates, Twins, Blue Jays, that nice Chris Bryant auto, and the Padres, Last Bought Mojo. All right. I do like the aggressiveness of that of the trade, though. I guess I didn't think Shelby Miller was going to be that bad, and I didn't think Swanson would move the rank so quickly. I guess if you think about it, I mean, it's kind of hard to trade that number one overall. I think I do remember thinking that if you make that trade, I felt like they should have gotten more. They still sent away Enciarte, too. I don't think they got too much back. But I guess you never know, you know. We could look through all the number one draft picks in baseball and see which one have made it and which ones have it. I wonder what the, in like the last, I don't know, 20 years, you know, I wonder how many have made it to be at least everyday players and how many like have not. In fact, we're going to do that after this break if we have time. I don't know, that National Treasures might be sold out, but if we have time, we're going to do that because now I'm curious. Because I'm sure there will be some points where you can make the case, man, you should have traded that number one pick. Darren Porter's hot take, hot fire take, is that the first player from this draft to make it to the bigs will be Will Benson, right? Indians guy, I think. It's interesting. A lot of high schoolers in this draft. I guess if you're in college when you got drafted in this draft, I guess you'll have a better chance of making it to the bigs first. Your autograph right here, Forrest Whitley, another Astros auto, going to Daniel Pelletier. Nice one, Dan. Nice Francisco Lindor, 125 out of 250. Nice one for the Tribe, speaking of which. Michael Littleby. And there we go, Reds, Robert Stevenson. One of their higher prospects there. Robert Stevenson, nice on-card auto, Joseph G. Cincinnati Reds. All right, next one. Pack Fresh saying the general manager for the Arizona teams are just trash. Phoenix Suns and D-backs have way too many regrets. There's Dansby Swanson, speaking of regrets for the Diamondbacks, 59 out of 99. That goes to the Braves, of course. Your autograph is a nice Orlando Arcia. Nice. For the Brew Crew, going out to David Cruz. Nice one, Dave. They like the Orlando Arcia up there in Milwaukee. He's a good one.
2 and 6. All right, so you want
should be expecting one more autograph. There it is. It's going to be... There's Will Benson. We were just talking about Will Benson. Darren Potter Porter's Subway hot take was that Will Benson of this draft class would be the first one to make it to the majors. Nice. Cleveland Indians. That'll go to Michael G. There's Will Benson again. Aha. Okay, so I believe there's only one mirror image atomic refractor in this per case. So I will randomize this separately from the other mirror image cards, just FYI. All right, so another nice box. So a couple nice inserts of Swanson and Lindor, and your autographs were Benson, Arcia, Stevenson, and Forrest. All right. Get some iced tea. And the next box. TJ needs some Nationals action here. Pack Fresh saying, oh yeah, D-backs paid too much. That they definitely paid a little much for Zach Greinke. I mean, even the Dodgers balked at matching that offer. I think Zach Greinke should be fine though. I think just a lot of bad things happened at what, like, we're like worst case scenarios happen, you know. AJ Pollock got injured, you know, and Greinke was overpaid, and Shelby Miller got injured and just had felt the weight of that trade, you know what I mean? And it just things just didn't click right for the Diamondbacks. Now, as a Dodger fan, I was totally fine with that. But as a baseball fan, that's just the way it goes sometimes. It sucks. But that's kind of what happened. But I think Greinke should be fine. Even with that money. Even with the money paid. I think that first season with the Diamondback has to be probably the worst season of the contract. I guess until the very last of the contract. But you got to expect at least a 3-4 seasons of, like, potentially, like, Cy Young, top 10 Cy Young voting kind of performances from Greinke before the tail end of that contract. That's what I think about Jason Hayward, too, out there in Chicago for the Cubs. I think that first year of that contract has to be Jason Hayward's worst year, right? And then he should make do through the rest. Well, one hopes. Josh Hader for the Brewers. Nice, another Brewer for Dave Cruz. It looks like we have a redemption coming up. Speaking of the Diamondbacks, there's Goldschmidt. And the redemption is... there are some common redemptions here. You're welcome, Dave. Atomic, huh? Michael Conforto, nice. I don't think I've seen that one yet. Atomic parallel as well. It's kind of like their cracked ice sort of look. So nice one for the Mets going out to Richard Krester. Nice. And another bonus auto. Wow. Chris Sale. So we had Chris Bryant in this version right here. And now Chris Sale, White Sox, Ed Aarons. 39 out of 50 on that one, Ed. A Bowman's Choice autograph card. White Sox edition. Nice. What a case. There's Rafael Devers. Nice one for the Red Sox. That'll go to Bruce. There you go, Bruce. Got you on the board. Good to see you. All right. That's Red Sox edition of Anderson Espinosa. I think his autograph is his Padres edition, though. You got another, got a Chris Bryant. This one's numbered. Out of 250 right there. The next one is... Drew Jackson, Mariners. And that will go to Alexander L. Great, great case. One, two, three, four, five autographs in here. Another box of the bonus auto. Mariners, Red Sox, White Sox, Mets, and Brewers. Well, there you go, Pat Fresh. He's no one's like, well, I spent half my life in Illinois, half in Arizona, grew up a Cubs fan, gradually became a Diamondbacks fan. Can't complain, though. Seen both teams in pretty phenomenal World Series. That is true. NL West should be pretty competitive, I think. You know, Giants always play well. I think San Francisco Giants, my rivals, you know, picked up Mark Melanson. That helps the back end of their rotation. The Dodgers kind of re-signed some key guys, and you know, they're hoping their young guys will take the next step. They got a lot of good young players, you know, so they're set. And the Diamondbacks, their record was worse than what their team actually is. Their record was not representative of the quality of that team. If the Rockies ever get their pitching in order, you know, which is tough considering where they play. But they've got a really underrated offense. I mean, it's not talked about too much, you know, because I think people just kind of dismiss it because of the fact that they play in Colorado. But if you look at their home away splits, they're actually pretty good on the road as well. So the Rockies actually have a really good offense, and if their pitching ever gets in order, that could be a surprise team as well. So NL West is going to be pretty competitive, I think. Speaking of the Dodgers, there's Dodgers coming up right here. There's Blake Snell, 175 out of 250, and the Dodgers, Gavin Lux. Nice, one of the Dodgers' highly touted prospects. One of many. There you go, Gavin Lux for the Dodgers. A little Dodger Joe mojo going to Scott Smith. Thanks, Scott, for grabbing the Dodgers. Stephen Piscotty, Atomic. And A.J. Reed, Astros having a hell of a break. Daniel, there you go, man. Pelletier with that one. That's strong. You got the Bregman, the Forrest Whitley, and the A.J. Reed. Two more. And a green autograph. Speaking of the Rockies. Speaking of offense, 30 out of 99, Trevor Story was a great story last year. Andy Owens with the Rockies, numbered as well. Is that home runs and RBIs? That could be this season. That'd be nice, right? They take that. Any team would take that. And speaking of the Diamondbacks, speaking of the NL West, there's Anthony Banda. Nice one for Arthur and the Diamondbacks. And Jacob Hill will get this Blake Snell numbered card. Nice parallel. Nice NL West box. This was a divisional. Be happy. Diamondbacks, Rockies, Astros, and Dodgers. Oh, nice. I just missed that, Pack Fresh. You were saying that you got the start of the Cubby spring training games. Oh, nice. You got season tickets for this, for the spring games? Nice. I think I'll be there in Arizona late March to maybe, I think some of my fantasy baseball buddies and I are getting together to draft. We do it's a 16 team keeper league auction draft, so it's a pretty hefty league. So I'm doing that, I believe, if we can organize all of that, then maybe taking in a spring training game or two. I haven't been to a Dodgers spring training game until since they moved from Vero Beach to Arizona, so I'll be pretty excited to check that out this season. I guess even if the draft falls through, I'll still probably try to go out there and catch a game. Maybe we'll break out there. We did that last year. Nick went out to Arizona last year with Panini to do that. Maybe we'll do that again. And there you go. We were talking about Anderson Espinosa earlier. We said that his autograph is as a Padre. So, last spot mojo hitting again for Joe G. Anderson Espinosa, Padres autograph. And Felix Hernandez, 32 out of 35. Nice one for the Mariners. That'll go to Alexander L. And Corey Ray for the Brewers. Nice. That'll go to David Cruz. Another one for Dave. Goes along nicely with that Orlando Arcia I pulled for you earlier. Let's find out, And we've got Mickey. What a case. Mickey Moniak. There you go, man. King D was worried that with the quality of this case, that Moniak was not going to be possible. But there he is, man. Nice one. Big draft pick there for the Phillies. And wow, Dansby Swanson, what a case. 20 out of 50. Baseball America insert, Dansby Swanson, Jacob Hill, and the Braves. Can you believe this case? Think about it. Two big vet autos and Chris Sale. Well, not, I mean, Chris Bryant's a second-year player, but still, we got pulled that auto of the NL MVP. Got a nice vet auto in Chris Sale. And we've been pulling a lot of the big players in this one, too. I mean, overall, it's just been a pretty strong case. And Anderson Espinosa, no slouch either. One of the best you've seen, right? Yeah, it's pretty nice. I mean, TJ, this case might be incredible enough to pull you that Bryce Harper auto out of here too. That's how good this case has been looking. We got 8 autos to go. Some pretty good odds there for everybody to get a hit. Darren says, I've seen a ton of Bowman's best, and this is at the top. I'd have to say so, you know. I mean, what are we missing? All we got to do is get, like, an AJ Puck, maybe, a Riley Pint, you know, some of the other, like, top 5, top 10 guys. And then, you know, that would make it really great. Maybe a super fractor, maybe a really low numbered card, like an out of 10, out of 5, a 1 of 1. Yeah, I already got you one, Arthur. Arthur wants more. I don't blame you. All right, 2 boxes go, 8 autographs to go. All right, here we go. Miggy. And Sean Newcomb, more Braves. Jacob Hill. There's Alex Bregman out of 250 for the Astros. And the autograph is going to be Aaron Blair. Wow, Braves finishing strong. There you go, Jacob Hill. Blake Snell, we had a nice numbered insert of his, and now we have ink. There we go, Tampa Bay Rays. That's also Jacob Hill. There you go, Jake. Nicely done, man. Rafael Devers, Atomic. Are you numbered? I don't think those ones are numbered. Corey Seager, revealing. Carlos Rodon. Nice Carlos Rodon. This is a great case. Ed Ahrens with the White Sox. And Bumgarner and Max Scherzer out of 99. It's a little something for the Nationals, but we need a little more than that for TJ. Chris Sale right here. All right, last box. Oh, you're on your phone, Arthur? Well, TJ was saying that he was getting a lag too. I wonder if that's for people on a mobile device. There you go. Well, and what was your trivia? Now that I'm going to be opening up packs, Darren had a trivia question. Can you name the last player to jump right to the majors with no minor league ball? 2010, speaking of pub quizzes, Conquering Lion, here's another quiz question. From 2010? Did you already give the answer? Darren, what's the answer on that? Was it 2010? Hunt saying Mike Leake. And the Dodgers did get Sergio Romo, who I think grew up a Dodger fan. Is it Richard for the win? Nice. I think he answered pretty quickly. I don't think he Googled it. Oh, he lives in Cincy. There you go. I was like, that was kind of fast. Oh, that was a little quick. All right, last one. Four autographs to go. Good luck to TJ. Good luck to everybody. Listen, TJ, if I don't get you the Bryce Harper here, then I think you have him in National Treasures, right? So, so maybe all that mojo will go there. All right, four autographs to go. Good luck, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for getting into this break. I see a lot of orders coming in. Almost 10 orders coming in. So I think we may have... Is National Treasures full? I might see National Treasures was down to one, I think, last we checked. All right. First autograph, Braxton Garrett. I've not seen a Braxton Garrett in a little while. Miami Marlins, Albert. That one, there you go. Tristan is here saying, new breaking with you guys, welcome. And says, just bought the Titans in Playbook. All right, yeah, Playbook should happen tonight too. We have plenty of time, folks. And wow, Gurriel for the Astro. I think you may have hit every single Astro auto here, Daniel. Ulysses Gurriel, who caused a lot of commotion when he was up for bid, I think. Gleyber Torres, 29 out of 150, Baseball America insert. Will Craig, Pittsburgh Pirates. That will go to Rick T with an autograph. And the last one, Zach Collins. Another one for Ed Ahrens with the Collins. Nice. And that does it, ladies and gentlemen. What a great break. Chris Bryant autograph. Chris Sale autograph. A lot of the top draft picks were in here, including Moniak. And we close out with White Sox, Pirates, another Astro, and a Marlin. Very cool. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Got a quick randomizer to do. Two quick ones for those mirror image cards and then the atomic mirror image card. So let's get the randomizer set up here. All right, we'll do left, right. Then we'll do mirror image, Cubs, or cards. We'll randomize each list 9 times, 4 and a 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9th and final time. Left side will get it. So for just these regular mirror image cards, all the teams on the left will be getting it. And then Cubs and Cardinals, that's for the atomic version. That's only one per case. 9 times, good luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, I said 9, right? Yeah, 5 more times. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9th and final time. Cubbies with that one. Michael G. You will get the Atomic Refractor version of these mirror image cards. There you go. Excellent. And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. That was Pick Your Team number 11 of Bowman's Best Baseball on the 16th of February. This is Joe. We'll see you next time on JaspysHobbyland.com.